In the fifth session, now we are going to discuss the Otto cycle in detail. Now let us see what is the outcome that you must be able to evaluate and analyze the Otto cycle, that is PV and TS diagram, and most probably the expression for efficiency of the engine. Now in the last sessions, we have seen that air standard cycle plays a very important role in the analysis of IC engines, and we'll go for the Otto cycle. Now Otto cycle is used for the SI engines, that is the petrol engines. Now if I draw this cycle on PV diagram and TS diagram, the picture will be more clear to you. This is the TS diagram and this is the PV diagram. Now here, if I go from this, say 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4 and 4 to 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1. Then on the TS diagram, this is 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4 and 4 to 1. Now we will analyze this cycle in detail. Now see what is happening here. 1 to 2, 1 to 2 and 3 to 4, these are PV raised to gamma is equal to constant, and these two processes are V is equal to constant. So what is expected, that you must know that this is the heat addition, that is the QS, and this is the heat rejection, that is QR. So in the PV diagram, this particular area will represent the work done, and efficiency we know that it is equal to work done upon energy input. So efficiency term is going to be a standard term, that is the QS minus QR upon QS. That is standard definition that we have used. Now see here, on the TS plot, we have got 1 to 2, which is the isentropic process, 2 to 3, which is the constant volume process, and this one. Now what is the physical meaning of this? This is very important, because what it indicates, that we are supplying heat essentially at constant volume. Now first see, at constant volume we are supplying heat, and at constant volume we are rejecting heat. Then there is other process in which we supply heat at constant pressure, reject heat at constant volume. That is called as a diesel cycle. And we have a third cycle, which is a dual cycle. The problem is that with the actual applications, we cannot supply heat entirely at constant volume. Some part of the heat gets added during constant pressure. Some part of the heat we have to add during the constant volume process, and that cycle becomes a dual cycle. So practically speaking, we don't have, say, theoretically perfect diesel cycle, but all our engines operate, which are the operating on the fuel diesel, they operate essentially on dual cycle. That is, some part is supplied in the constant volume region, some part is supplied in the constant pressure region. Now, as it is air standard cycle, as I am doing my analysis for per kg, that is, if I take m is equal to 1 kg, or m dot is equal to 1 kg per second. So for per kg second, kg per second, I can do the analysis. Now I know that when a constant volume process is taking place, heat supplied is equal to mCV delta T. This is my definition. This I know from thermodynamics. Now it is mCV. Now what is delta T? Delta T is T3 minus T2 in this situation. Similarly, if I see Q rejected, it is again mCV T4 minus T1. See, specifically I use this T4 minus T1 when I say it is QR. If I write heat interaction, that is Q, it is simply mCV is equal to final minus initial, that is T1 minus T4. Looking at the diagram, it is clear to me that T1 is going to be less than T4. So naturally, this quantity is going to be negative. So instead of using a negative quantity and adding it algebraically to the heat supplied, it is better that we call it rejected. We know that it is minus, and we write this in the expression, this one. Otherwise, this is algebraic sum of the Q divided by total heat supplied. It is not single Q, it is a total heat supplied. So theoretically speaking, this particular is the algebraic sum. This is also algebraic sum, because many times students make mistake. When the cycle is shown to them, it is not necessary having four processes. Suppose 6-7 processes are there. Means 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, 7 to 8, and again 8 to 1. And in these processes, in some parts we supply heat, some parts we reject heat. So when we calculate the efficiency of an engine, what is important is area under the curve is going to be always the work output. That is no problem. But heat supplied that we have to divide is the total amount of heat supplied in various processes. And that's why it comes as here as this one. Now, if I know this, then I can derive the expression for efficiency. Now, derivation of expression for efficiency for Otto cycle. So we'll write the efficiency of air standard efficiency, that is ASC, for Otto cycle, if I write it. So it becomes Q supplied minus Q rejected. So it is MCV T2 minus T1 minus MCV T4 minus T1 divided by MCV T2 minus T1. This is my heat supply. So I know that if I divide this, MCV, MCV will get cancelled from all this. And I will get T2 minus T1 minus T4 plus T1. So in the top, I will get T2 minus T1 minus T4 plus T1 divided by T2 minus T1. Or if I do it systematically, if I divide this, I will get 1 minus T4 minus T1 upon T2 minus T1. So this is my expression. Now what happens when we work in thermodynamics? We are interested in finding out all our answers in terms of pressure ratios, in terms of compression ratios, and so many other things. Now let us see, for this particular situation, if I write this expression once again, that is, you write here for your convenience, 1 minus T4 minus T1 upon T2 minus T1. Now if I see the cycle, that is say PV diagram, then it is clear to me that 1 to 2, 2 to 3 and 3 to 4. This is my PV diagram. Now, if I could find the values of this T4 minus T1 and T2 minus T1 in terms of compression ratio. Now, what is the compression ratio? I have got here V1, I have got here V2, which is also equal to V3, which is also equal to V4. So, V1 by V2 is equal to V4 by V3 is equal to R. This R is called as a compression ratio. And the index that I have here, it is PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. So gamma has got different value for monoatomic, for air. So for monoatomic, it is 1.67. For gamma for air, it is 1.4. And gamma for exhaust gas, if I take exhaust gas, it is 1.3 or something. Means final expression for efficiency that we are evaluating, it may happen that it will depend upon the compression ratio and gamma and other values. Okay, now if I see the process, that is, I want T4 minus T1 and T2 by T1. So I have a ratio V1 by V2 and V2, V4 by V3 is equal to R. So what I will do for 1 to 2, if I go for process 1 to 2. Now what is this process? It is P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2. I am interested in finding out the value of T2 by T1, say for example. So I will get T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 into V2 by V1 because it is the ratio of this. And also I know that P1 V1 raised to gamma is equal to P2 V2 raised to gamma. So now I want in terms of V2 by V1 because V2 by V1 is known to me. And this P2 by P1, I will calculate T2 by T1 in terms of V2 by V1. Now P2 by P1, P2 by P1, if I see here, P2 by P1 will be V1 by V2 raised to gamma. V1 by V2 raised to gamma. And this is V2 by V1 raised to 1. Now this is actually V1 by V2 and this is V2 by V1. So if I make it reciprocal, it will become V1 by V2 raised to gamma minus 1. So in short, it is R raised to gamma minus 1. This is my first part. Similarly, for process 3 to 4, if I go for 3 to 4, I will get the same thing, that is say P3 V3 upon T3 is equal to P4 V4 upon T4. And P4 V4 raised to gamma is equal to P3 V3 raised to gamma. Now I am interested in the value of T4 by T1. T4 by T1. Now if I want T4 by T1, what I will get? I will get T4 by T1. T4 by T3 is equal to P3 P4 V4 upon P3 V3. And in the same vein, I can write this P4 by P3 into V4 by V3. Now I know that V4 by V3 is equal to R, and this is P4 by P3. So P4 by P3 I will write in with the help of this equation, P4 by P3 is equal to V3 by V4 raised to gamma. So if I put this into V4 by V3, so I will get this as V3 by V4 raised to gamma minus 1. V3 by V4 raised to gamma minus 1. So I got this particular same values. So by putting the values in this expression for the efficiency here, I will get 1 minus 1 upon R raised to gamma minus 1. So I will get the answer as 1 minus 1 upon R raised to gamma minus 1. Now here what happens, if I draw the graph of efficiency versus compression ratio, then I will see that this particular graphs I get for different values of gamma is equal to 1.67, gamma is equal to 1.4, gamma is equal to 1.3. Now same logic we can apply for diesel cycle, we can apply for dual cycle, and we can get the answers. Now in this cycle we have studied the effectiveness of the particular engine, which is actual engine, we have to convert it into auto engine so that it is air standards efficiency we have derived, and the same problem we can solve for the diesel and dual, that we can see in the next sessions. Those who are interested in studying further, they can see internal combustion engine by Haywood and internal combustion engine by Gupta. And for this session, once again I say thank you for patient listening.